Hi, everyone. Jeff Cote with another Boating Tech Talk. We've got a question from a fellow boater, Rick, who's asking questions about fusing a solar wire on a solar array. Hey, Jeff, I watch your video sizing a solar controller based on your boat's voltage. Following your advice, I'm installing a 100-watt solar panel. For the fuse connection before the batteries, can I use a 10-amp mini fuse or do I need to use a regular fuse? Well, fuses...
There's
different types of fuses for sure. And on a solar panel install, generally I would recommend, and for most of us boaters, I recommend the ATO-ATC fuse. These are automotive blade fuses. And the reason why I recommend them is A, because they're color-coded and so they're easy to identify the size. Glass fuses sometimes break in the holder and it can be, a hassle to clean up the glass. And blade fuses also are way easier to detect if they're blown than a glass fuse. So if you're putting fuses on your solar controller, of course, it's a preference. Some people prefer a glass, some people prefer blade. I like blade, like I said, because they're color coordinated and they're easier to detect when the filament inside is blown. And you can even buy them with an LED inside, and they'll actually show you, this is the best part, they'll actually show you and they'll be bright red, let's say, if the fuse actually blew. So the size of the fuse, when you choose it, the other thing too is making sure the wiring can handle the loaded. So when you're choosing a fuse holder, and in this case it's not going to be a problem because the circuit, 100 watt solar panel is going to be outputting maybe max 5-6 amps total max, so 10 amp is really good. But make sure your fuse holder is sized to handle the maximum amperage. And that becomes more of a problem, let's say, if you've got a large solar array. If your solar array is now maybe 400 watts or 500 watts, and you're exceeding, let's say, 20 amps or 30 amps, not all fuse holders are the same. So you need to make sure that the fuse holder can handle the continuous amperage coming out of the panel. That's really important. And when I mean from the panel, it goes from the panel to the controller to the battery. And so that connection at the battery from the battery to the controller needs to absolutely have a fuse holder that is rated for the maximum amperage of that panel. So to Rick's question, he can really do both, but I strongly advise and suggest that you put automotive ATO, ATC blade fuses just because they're just easier to deal with. And they're easier to swap out, easier to know when they're blown. So great question, Rick. Thanks for asking. And to all of you out there, share your stories about fuses. And by the way, one last thing, carry spare fuses on board. I've got a spare fuse for everything on board. I'm always happy I have a little set because sometimes fuses blow just for nuisance tripping. It does happen. Some things happen and it's not catastrophic. And the only thing you need is a fuse. So be sure to carry that. Safe boating, and thanks for watching. So if you're curious again, go on our website and find out more answers and solutions with this sort of setup. And thanks for asking, and thanks for all of you for listening and tuning in.